So dear Lord, just want to thank you for the past few nights. I want to thank you and give you praise for tonight. You know, and hopefully just like my youth, you know, hopefully tonight we don't just wait for God, or we don't just wait for someone to lead us there. We don't just wait for this worship team to lead you all towards God. But you know, each and every one of us, we can truly be part of this worship. We can truly be part of this prayer as we lead one another. You know, by our voices, by our gifts, by our talents, from wherever we are. You know, because we truly believe in His Lord, and hence we are singing, hence we are praising. You know, let this night be a night where we truly encounter, not because we are in church, but because we believe. You know, and many of us, you know, for the past few nights we've been coming because we have an expectation. We are asking for something. But maybe tonight we can just stand before God, stand before the cross, stand before the altar. And say that, Lord, we are here because we have been given. We have been given first. And whether or not you're going to give anything else to us, we are really grateful, we are really thankful, and we want to praise you. We want to praise you for the struggles that we already have. We want to praise you for the past few lives, because in every struggle that we've gone through has led us to exactly this point where we are today, right here, right now. So we praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. Help us. Help us to praise you. Help us. And as we just take the first song, we just want to lift our hands. You know, lift our voices. Who we are. Who we were created to be. Created by love. Created from love. To love and to be love. Amen.
Amen.
Are we really praise God?
Yes.
Here we go.
Thank you. Father, here we are in your presence today. We're in this sacred place, we're on holy ground. God, your presence is so wonderful, glorious. You are wonderful and glorious, and no one else can match up to you. Not even the good and desirable things of this earth. None of them can match up to you. God, in your presence, something mysterious, but something so great. When we come before you, we feel a sense of comfort, sense of joy, and peace as well. This unexplainable peace. And I know that wherever I come from in the day, wherever we come from the day, when I just come into your presence, oh Lord, something unexplainable always happens.
Suddenly by the way. we are undone. And in your presence, all things are made new. So I just invite you to close your eyes and to think of the week. To think of the week that's about to end. The joys and the joys. And as you think about all these, I invite you to imagine Jesus, especially in those times where you could have been hurt or felt any dis-ease through what people say or what people do to you. I invite you to think of those times with Jesus by your side. And you notice that He is always with you, that He is always watching over you, for He is strong and mighty. And He's promised that He will stay with you forever. And so, Lord, today as we come, we long for your presence, we long for you. And all you ask for us is to offer our lives as a form of worship to you every day. And yet, it is very difficult for us, Lord. But thank you for showing us the way. For you offered your life first for our salvation. And Jesus, in you we will find strength and hope and love and peace. And so, Father, as this song is our prayer to you. Our prayer every day of our lives to offer it to you. For we know that when we offer our hearts and our hands and when we lift it up to you, you can do great things. You can do marvelous things, Lord.
Oh, my God. Lord's name, we offer ourselves to you today. We bring ourselves, all our brokenness, all our pride, our hurts, our joy, our sorrow. We put it down at the feet of your cross, where you died for each and every one of us here today. Open our hearts, Father. Let us receive everything that you have given us and that you will give us in the future. You have plans to prosper us, to bring us to heaven, to give us all these wonderful things. Our biggest dreams are not even the biggest. It's not even enough. You are all that you have. The plans that you have for us are marvelous, just that we don't know yet, but you are there for us and you are always there for us every step of the way. You love each and every one of us here today so dearly. You made us in your image. You knew us right from the very start. Father, we thank you, Father. Father, today we come as your beloved children. For we call you Abba, Father, our strength, our hope, the lover of our soul, the mighty comforter. Let us take that step towards you today, Father, to consciously say that you are our God, our Father, our strength, our hope giver. As we lead our lives day by day, we often forget and we get sucked into the secular world where we lead two lives, our church lives, our home lives, our work lives. But today, God our Father receives us for who we are. He embraces us wholeheartedly, along with all our limitations, our insecurities, our trespasses, and we come as who we are. We come as who we are, broken people, to come to praise Him with a heart full of worship, right here, right now, tonight. It's all about you tonight, Father. It's all about you. Your sacrifice, your love, your grace. It's all about you, Father.
Something that's all but a
worries or the big challenges we have in our lives. We surrender everything, every little thing, every small challenge, big challenge, we surrender it all to you, Father. Because you, Father, are looking right into our hearts right now, right here, and you know us better than any other person on earth. You know us the best. And let us throw away all our insecurities, all our burdens, our struggles, and focus on you, Father. Your presence, your Holy Spirit. Let us focus on that today, brothers and sisters in Christ. Tonight, you are the star, and you are the star that we have come to adore and praise. It's all about you.
Spirit.